Hello, everyone. That's Jess Penny. And today I am working with a new little mini journal. It's also could be a prayer pocket as well. The little mini journal was designed to actually fit into a pocket. And I have all the little pieces already pre-cut. I've got some junk papers over here that I'm going to be working with. So hopefully we can put everything together. Now I've chosen, this is a different color, obviously, but there is some green and there's some of this teal blue in her earrings. So I was hoping to bring out some of the color and I've chosen an envelope. This is just, I got an envelope at a thrift shop. So I wanted to kind of use what I had, and I had this color envelope. I've got the kit already cut out. This piece is the pocket, and this piece here, it has no spine. So these two were pages because there's no spine here, and these two were the covers, and you could put them just like this, okay, so that you would have the front cover, you know, or you could make this the front cover, however that you wanted to do it, okay? So you would have the inside cover and the front cover. Does that make any sense? Okay? And then the spine, of course, you would score here and score here to make your little spine. And if you wanted to make it a real sturdy book, then, you know, a little sturdy journal, then you could absolutely put some reinforcing this in here. But right now, I just really want to make like a little daily prayer book or a little scripture little book to actually go inside the pocket. So I don't want it too fat, and I don't want to have a really like a hard spine. I want it to be a soft spine. And then, I, of course, I have my little elements over here of the lady and then some flowers and things from the kit. And, of course, I've got some junk papers as well because, obviously, you know, I want to make kind of like a little mini junk journal type prayer type thing. And so, yeah. So, let's get started into making the little mini journal to go in my little pocket. First of all, I'm going to start making the pocket because the journal will take a little bit of time. You're going to need either an awl, a needle, an awl, or and some thread, or you can use a stapler. And since I send these through the mail now, I'm going to need to just use a needle and thread because obviously, you know, that doesn't want to go through the mail very well. Staple does it. So I'm just getting some thread and my awl. And looks like both of my awls have been bent for some reason. Look at that. Look, does y'all see that? I must have been doing some heavy poking with these. No worries. I've got a hubby that can fix those. So, no worries on that. Okay, so, let's push this aside. I'm going to push these over here out of the way. And let's begin to make the pocket. So, I have an envelope. And I thought, well, that's lovely, you know. It doesn't quite go with the color, but yet it still kind of goes with the earrings that's in her, you know, that she has. So I'm gonna try to use some of this blue, I think it's navy type ink pad to give it kind of tie it in all together, if that makes any sense. And I'm not really worried about distressing too much, but I just want it to pop out. Kind of change the color around it. Not really totally changing the color, but anyway, there. Now, if I wanted it even darker, I could come back in with my black, and because I always like to double up different ink colors. So, because this one has a little bit of that charcoal navy around it. So, But if I wanted to blacken it up a little bit, I could. You know, the edges get to kind of match. But I think I'm going to come in here with this blue. And make it, oh, that's a lot better. A lot better there. Okay, so now I know that to make a pocket, of course, you only glue on the three sides. And I want to make sure that the little journal will fit, you know, in here properly. And that's how I designed it, was so that the little journal, mini journal, would fit in here. Hopefully my glue gun is ready to go. And usually I just use a glue gun. You can use whatever glue that you want to use. And I'm using a glue gun, I'm kind of squeezing, smear, so I don't have, like, bumps and ridges. And you have to act kind of fast with a glue gun. And I have this little silicone makeup brush from the Dollar Tree. And I use it two ways. I use it that way. And then, of course, use it that way as well. Okay, so now here's the pocket. And I kind of want to decorate the pocket. I kind of want to, you know, do something. Because this is going to go paper clipped into my journal. Or it can be, it can be inserted in your journal with this, you know, in the spine if you're doing a journal. And you can flip it like so. But since I mail these, of course I couldn't mail it like this, you know. But, well, I guess I could. I could put the address here. But I'm going to actually use this to be put into a journal. I'm going to paper clip it into my Bible or my journal. Or I'm going to send it like in a mail, you know, as a prayer pocket. So I haven't decided quite yet. But I want to make sure if I want to design, if I want to go this way, or if I want to go this way. And this would be awful big, awful wide to go in a Bible. You know, if it was this way, it'd be very wide. Depending on what your Bible. But since I have a big, large Bible, I think I'm going to stick it in it. I think it will work fine. So I'm going to make sure that my pocket is here, and then I have another secret pocket if I wanted to add anything like prayers or you know, letters to the Lord, I can do back there.